4 weeks now, they've been arriving by the thousands. On this night, over 3,000 Syrian refugees cross into Jordan. Those who can walk carry a few possessions. Others help those who can't. Some arrive injured and in need of medical attention, like this elderly man. For most, their flight from a country at war has been traumatic. Abu Ali walked 10 days with his family from Damascus.
المنطقة اللي احنا كنا فيها ثمن قذائف ضربونا. فتنا بين الدور تخبينا حتى خدت شوي حتى غابت الشمس.
They left home because of death threats, he explains, but the dangers were all along the way.
ما طلعنا بكيفنا من الوطن بس عنف عنا وقصب عنا. يعني اذا ما بتطلع بدك تموت. ما في مجال يعني. الموت محتم لك 100%.
Tonight's exodus includes young and old.
والله ما بدي اطلع والله ولا ما اجوا علينا وحرقونا الدور ما بدنا نطلع يدبوا علينا بالطياره اسمه فوق تحت.
UNHCR is assisting the Jordanian government in looking after the refugees.
And from what we're hearing at the moment, we're likely to see entire villages probably coming over in a not too distant future. People are giving up hope in certain parts of Dara. And like the woman I was just talking to then was 95 years old. Who's 95 and decides to leave their country?
The new arrivals are taken to a shelter, a tent erected by Jordanian border guards. Here they get water and blankets, basic things. Then they will be taken to Al-Zatri refugee camp. The border guards are all too aware of the dangers the refugees face.
عمليات اطلاق النار من قبل الجيش السوري على اللاجئين بتكون بالاراضي السوريه. وعاده قسم منهم يعود اذا كانت الرمايه قريبه منه، قسم منهم يكون قريب لحدودنا. بيدخلوا باتجاهنا واحنا بنقوم مساعدتهم بعد دخولهم اراضينا. احنا لا نتدخل في حدود اي دوله اخرى. وعندما يدخلوا اراضينا وبكونوا تحت السياده الاردنيه والتراب الاردني احنا نقوم بعمليه مساعدتهم فقط.
This elderly Syrian woman is safe now, but she's been separated from her family. She's not even sure if they were able to get across. The scale of the people crossing means that the needs only grow.
We've got the capacity, we've got the space, we've certainly got the willingness from a very generous government, generous people, but we need to put the money into the healthcare, into the education side, into the shelter, into the food, into the water, because providing support for over 300,000 people takes a lot of resources, and we could be looking at 500,000 in a month or two. We could be looking at 700,000. So we need that money now, so we're better prepared.
At one point, the border lights are turned off. A guard climbs into a watchtower. There is a security threat. Suddenly, more refugees come across. UNHCR has predicted that within the coming months there could be a million Syrian refugees in Jordan, Lebanon, Turkey, and Iraq. People who didn't want to leave their country, but had to.